So this is our 2020 Hyundai Ioniq electric, and in this video I'm just going to talk about this little device which I've got on the 12 volt battery here, which is a 12 volt battery monitor. So this car is obviously 100% electric, but all electric cars still have a traditional old lead acid 12 volt battery, and these are the biggest source of problems on electric cars. Just like a combustion engine car, if your 12 volt battery goes flat, you can't start your car. Obviously this isn't cranking over an engine, but it is still starting it. It's doing your central locking, turning on the dash, and switching on those contactors to enable the high voltage battery from under the floor is all being done by the 12 volt battery here. So if this is dead, your car won't start. And the issue with modern cars is they've got a lot more electronics, and crucially now telematics, because cars have got apps and the emergency system in them. So even when a car is shut down, they're still consuming electricity, particularly for opening and shutting the app and talking to the car. Then that is all being done by the 12 volt battery. And what you can find is your car could be in use one day, even charged overnight, but come the morning, your 12 volt battery is flat. And that's what this little device does. It just monitors it, and it means that you get an alert if your 12 volt battery is crucially getting low, and hopefully it doesn't catch you out in the morning and leave you stranded. These little things, it's just stuck on here with a little bit of a sticker, but it's just that little box there, and you wire it up to your positive terminal and negative terminal. And then what that does is it talks to an app on your phone, and it's a little Bluetooth monitor. They only cost about £25 on Amazon. I'll put a link to it in the video description below. But I think for any modern car, they are well worth spending the money on to give you that peace of mind, and crucially to give you, hopefully, in most scenarios, will give you that advance warning that your battery has got problems before it catches you out in the morning, which is always going to be the worst time, because probably you're rushing off to get to work, and this thing just might save you. So I've jumped in the car now to get away from that background noise of the traffic, because I know that never sounds very good on the videos, but nothing I can do about it here. So let's describe what it does. So that little device under the bonnet strapped to the battery is a Bluetooth device, and it's recording the voltages of the battery all the time, every 20 or 30 seconds or so, and then it's storing it. And then you run an app on your phone, and when your phone is within Bluetooth reach of the car, you get a notification if it reaches a critical level. And when it doesn't, at any point you can go into the app, and as long as you're within range of the car, which Bluetooth, what is it, 10 meters or so, you're going to see the condition of the battery here. So we're looking live now at the battery. The car's turned off, and we can see that the battery is at 12.24 volts. The battery is okay, and we can see a little graph here of the current status of the battery. And if I push that graph, we then go into a landscape mode, and we can see there what the battery has done today. Let me just put that on my lap there. Let me just see if I can get away from the reflections a little bit. No, I can't. But anyway, we can see there the battery voltage going up and down. This is obviously when the car has run. This is when the car's stopped. So it's sat dormant there. So looking at today, in the middle of the night, 12:30 in the morning, the car went on charge on off-peak electricity, so the battery had a bit of a charge, and then slowly it sat there till the morning, where the car was then used and the car got charged, and then it's been sat again, and then it's just had a little spike because the car was switched on not long ago, and then you can see it's now dipped down and it's just charging again. And we can switch to different days, and we can see the charging pattern of that 12 volt battery on every day. And what basically happens if it gets to below a certain threshold, I can't remember what I've got this one set to, probably 10 volts, something like that, you will then get a notification on your phone. So what I'm going to do now is start the car, and obviously when the car is running, the battery is being charged. Let me just turn that off. And let me just turn off the heating there. So as we can see there, the voltage has jumped up to 14.73 volts, and that's because the vehicle is now charging the 12 volt battery, and we can see it's jumped up there. So for most of the time, this app is just going to sit dormant and you're not going to refer to it, but it gives you that crucial notification if your battery has got problems. Because if it was a combustion engine vehicle and your battery was slowly dying, you would notice, because you would get in, you would turn the key, and you might notice that it struggles to start. And you would generally get a few days notice that your battery was struggling and you knew you had to replace it. But with an electric vehicle, your battery isn't doing that cranking of an engine in the morning, it's just sitting there running the dash and the central locking, and what you find is it could be getting low, but you don't notice it until it's suddenly hit that critical threshold where it can't cope, and suddenly you can't unlock the car in the morning, or you can't start the car in the morning. And this is going to give you that prior notice. And because it works on Bluetooth, most people will have their car parked within 10 meters of the house. So if you're, say, let's say you're in the front lounge, this is going to be within range of your car. And if that battery gets that critical level, you'll probably get a ping on your phone, because most of the time your phone is going to be within range. And that little device on the battery consumes minimal power. It's not going to make the 12 volt battery any worse. And it's not sort of, the app is running all the time on your phone, but you know, it only sort of kicks in when you're within Bluetooth range. This also does a few other things. We can do a cranking test. Obviously, that's not applicable to an EV, but if you started your engine, it will obviously measure that the alternator's kicked in and see that increased voltage, which basically is doing the same thing as the DC to DC converter's doing now. It's charging the battery while the vehicle's running. But you've got all of these cranking tests. We've also got an idle test. And the last thing is trip, and we can see all of the times the vehicle's ran and the battery's been charged. And there's various settings you can do, and set the thresholds and set the point here that it alarms you. And you can have two thresholds. So I've got one set at, I don't have my glasses, I think that says 60%, another alarm at 20%. So that's the times on this phone we're going to get the alarm when the battery gets to those sort of levels. So I'll turn the car off now, and the battery voltage is going to slowly drop down to its 12.5 volts because the charging has stopped. So as I said, if your battery is healthy, it's going to be fine, and you're just going to put this on your phone and forget about it, but it is going to help. And what I see happen a lot of times, particularly on these Ioniqs, is the batteries just suddenly die. And what I think that is the telematics. I think it's this BlueLink app, and we're not using BlueLink on this car because we didn't have it on our previous 28 kilowatt hour. So it's something that when you haven't got it, you don't miss it. So that's why it's still flashing up on the screen here. And your free trial of BlueLink is available, because we've never enabled BlueLink. And we've never had a 12 volt battery issue with this car. But what I'm finding online is other people have got these Ioniqs, obviously running BlueLink, and cars which are only a few months old are seeing dead 12 volt batteries. I even saw a case where one chap drove his car, I think he said 400 miles in a day, and got home, it went on charge that night, and in the morning his 12 volt battery was flat, even though it had loads of charge the day before, would have been completely fine. But it managed to fully drain itself during the night. Yet these cars have a system on it where it will top up the battery by itself during the night. And it flashes a light on the dash, a bit like a Nissan Leaf does or an EMV 200. Not many EVs do that, but the newer breed of Hyundais and Kias all do it. So you shouldn't be left stranded with a dead battery. But even so, these cars are still draining the battery, and this system where it wakes up and charges isn't enough to cope with it. Apparently some later software either solves it or helps it, but this system just hopefully will alert you before that's the case, before you're left with a stranded battery, and then you can go out and do something to solve it. And if that's the case and you get that alert to your phone, what you basically do will just be go out and switch the car on for a bit. Ideally leave it running, leave the car sat here on your driveway, and go back in and leave it running for half an hour, and then while it's running it's charging that battery up, and that will probably be enough to charge the battery back up. and then not leave you stranded in the morning, having that little notification to tell you that your battery's got issues just gives you that chance to do something about it. Either do as I said, just switch the car on, leave it running, or plug in a battery charger and charge your battery off the mains. So whatever car you've got, whether it's an electric vehicle or a combustion engine vehicle, these little things I think are brilliant. It's a once only purchase. It just wires up to your battery with a few couple of open spade connectors, so very easy to connect up. Just slacken the nut off, slide it in, do the nut back up. This one I had to nick a little bit of plastic out the side of the case there just to give it a little bit of room, but very easy to install and well worth the £25 or so that it cost for that bit of peace of mind, and just stops you getting caught out. I actually forgot to say what they were called. It's called Battery Monitor BM2. I know I've got this one installed upside down, but anyway, as I said, a link for it is in the description below. So that's it for this video. If you found it useful, as always, please do click that thumbs up button on YouTube. That really does help, and it helps other people find the channel. And if you want to know more about these cars, the Hyundai Ioniq, I'll put a link to a playlist below where you can look at all the other videos I've made on these cars. And I'll see you on the next video.